Hello friends, good afternoon. This is Ruchi Srivastav. Today I will be discussing addressing modes of 8085 microprocessor. Works with four addressing modes. These are: one is immediate addressing mode, second is register addressing mode, third is direct addressing mode, and the fourth one is indirect addressing mode. So we will see each of these one by one, starting with immediate addressing mode. So what is meant by immediate addressing? Immediate is something when we want to have anything just now, okay. So immediate action can be taken only when data is present. Suppose I want to have your pen. So if you are having your pen, then only I can have it immediately. Likewise, in 8085 microprocessor, there are some of the instructions which work for immediate action, like MVI, LXI. The full name of this instruction MVI is first C format. The format of MVI is MVI RD data. Okay. And the full name of MVI is move the given data immediately. I here stands for immediately. Move the given 8-bit data immediately into the specified register. Here data will be of 8. Okay. For example, if I write MVI A B 2 H. So what this instruction is saying, MV, that means move the given 8-bit data. What is the given 8-bit data? B2. The given 8-bit data immediately. I stands for immediately into the specified destination register. RD means destination register. So what this instruction will do? It will put this 8-bit data B2 into the accumulator immediately. So for any action, for any instruction, if we want immediate action to be taken, what is required? Data must be present within the instruction. So this is our immediate, that is why it is our immediate addressing mode. Similarly, another instruction for 8085 is, immediate action for 8085 is LXI. LXI is for 16-bit data. The format is LXI RP data, and data will be of 16-bit. For example, LXI B 4932H. If I write LXI B 4932H, what this instruction is saying, load, L stands for load, the given 16-bit data immediately into the specified register pair X. X here is representing that the register name here given here is not a single register, rather it is to be taken into pair. So that means this B is not a single register B, it will be our register pair BC. So what this instruction is saying, that load the given 16-bit data immediately, I stands for immediately into the specified register pair. Okay, fine. So for any case, if immediate action is to be taken place, that means data must be present within the instruction, right? Next we will see register addressing. register addressing. Register addressing, in register addressing, transfer of data is between two registers. That means there are two registers. The format is, there is only one instruction for register addressing, it is move. So move format is RD RS. Move the 8-bit data from the specified 8-bit source register to the specified 8-bit destination registers. For example, move A C. So C is our source register and A is our destination register. What will this instruction do? It will copy the data from the source register C to the destination register A. This instruction is only for 8-bit data. There is no instruction, no such register addressing mode for any 16-bit data. So this is this move RD RS. This is register addressing. Next, we have direct addressing. Actually, direct addressing is meant for transferring data between microprocessor and memory. Look here. This is our microprocessor and this is our memory or IO devices as well. So most of the times microprocessor has to communicate with memory. Microprocessor has to receive some data from memory and it has to send some data to the memory. So direct addressing is related with communicating with memory. When microprocessor has to receive some data from memory or it has to send some data to memory, it needs direct addressing. In case of direct addressing, microprocessor gives the address of data directly in the instruction. There are two instructions for this, LDA and STA. The format is LDA address. Similarly, STA address. Okay. And as we know that the address of memory in case of 8085 microprocessor is that of 16-bit, so this will be a 16-bit address. This also will be a 16-bit address. For example, if I write LDA 2001H, so what will this instruction do? The interpretation of this instruction is load the accumulator. LD stands for load the accumulator directly from the specified memory location. Load the accumulator directly from the specified memory location. So what will this instruction do? It will load an 8-bit data from this memory location, this 2001 memory location, somewhere. It will be somewhere in this memory. Suppose this 2001H. This is one memory location. It will be holding some 8-bit data. What will this instruction do? It will copy the 8-bit data from this memory location to the microprocessor by means of this LDA instruction. Similarly, STA 2002H. Okay. What does this instruction say? It says store, ST stands for store the content of accumulator to the specified memory location. So what will this instruction do? It will store the content of accumulator into this specified memory location. That means here there may be some location 2002 or something else. So content of accumulator from the microprocessor will flow to the specified memory location by means of this instruction. So we can see the address of data in this instruction is given directly, right? In immediate addressing, data itself is present in the instruction. In register addressing, data is not present. Data is simply copied from one register to another register. And in case of direct addressing, address of data is present in the instruction. Okay? In case of indirect addressing, address of data is not given directly. Rather, the address of data is given into some register and the name of the register is given into the instruction. Two instructions are used for this purpose, LDAX and STAX. Okay? So, when it was a direct addressing, it was LDA and we used to give the address. But in case of indirect addressing, name of register is given like this, LDAXB. So, when I write LDAXB, what happens? This instruction says that load, LD stands for load, the accumulator indirectly with the content whose address is in the specified register pair. I am repeating again, load the accumulator with the content of that memory location whose address is in the specified register pair. I have written here B, but B is an 8-bit register. Memory address will be having 16-bit, memory location will be having 16-bit address. So, X here is representing that B is not to be taken singly, rather it is to be taken in pair. That has a meaning, we have to take B, C register pair. Now, by some, we can say by means of immediate addressing, we may put the address suppose 2001 into the register BC, like LXI B 2001. When I write LXI B 2001, what will happen? 2001 will move into the register pair BC. And now, when I write after this instruction, if I write LDAXB, then what will happen? The content in BC, this instruction will take the content of register pair BC as an address and it will copy the data from that address into the accumulator. Now, BC is holding 2001 and this instruction will copy the data from this particular address to the microprocessor. This kind of addressing is actually used in case of array, when we have to deal with a number of data, not with a single data, rather with a group of data that are arranged in some sequence. So, in that case, indirect kind of addressing is required. Okay.